والفجر وليالي العشر والشفع والوتر. These 10 nights, on these 10 nights, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself taking the oath, which is indicating the importance after these 10 days after month of Zulhijjah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed some type of worship, like the Qurbani and the Hajj, which took place during these 10 days. The rest days after years, we cannot perform the Hajj. We cannot perform and we cannot sacrifice the animal for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the intention of the Qurbani. Because these two types of worship just took place in these days, which indicating the more importance of these days. What Ibn Abbas reported, that there are no good deeds which are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than good deeds which is performed during these 10 days of the Zulhijjah. If we perform a voluntarily prayer or doing more zikr in the normal days, these days are also valuable, we are being made valuable. But when we are doing more zikr during these days, and when we are going to be perform more voluntarily prayer, so then these are the more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the Sahabi Rasul, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even the jihad for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, yes, even the jihad for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most important than the jihad, if a person who is doing more zikr, who is doing more prayer, is a more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, unless a person who out for his home and go for the jihad and sacrifice his life and his wealth also, maybe he is more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though the person who is performing good deeds are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during these 10 days after Zulhijjah. What the special kind of worship, especially the Hajj, which took place during these first 10 days after Zulhijjah, especially on the 8th of Zulhijjah till the 12th of Zulhijjah, these are these 5 days in which the pillars of the fifth pillar of Islam, which is called Hajj, can be performed. The rest days of the year, we could not perform the Hajj, even though Arafah on its place, Mina on its place, Muzdalifah on its place, if one of us go and spend there the months and spend there the several nights, he could not achieve even the one day sawab what he achieved when he go and perform there the Hajj. This indicating that in the prayer is nothing, in the Hajj is nothing, all things should have to be with obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As all of us know, when one of us going to perform the one prayer in Masjid al-Haram, so he is getting the reward of 100,000 prayer. Then on the 8th of Zulhijjah, when the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the all pilgrimage, you should have to leave the Haram and go and, you know, resident there in the Mina, go there for one night and should have to pray there the 5 prayers. No one is going to be asked an excuse why I should have to believe the prayer, which one prayer reward is more than 100,000, and I perform prayer in the Mina. But all Hajis, they move from the Haram and go to the Mina, and they are performing the prayer. And they are leaving the sawab after one prayer, which is equal to the 100,000 prayer. Why? Because our religion Islam means obedience. So all the time we should have to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the logic behind the performing Hajj, and this is the same logic behind when we go to sacrifice the Qurbani, when we go to sacrifice the animal for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Regarding Qurbani, we should have to be realized and perform the Qurbani, should have to be sacrificed the animal on the specific days, which is the 10th, 11th and 12th. If any one of us miss these days, so we could not get the sawab of the Qurbani. Even in the rest days we are going to be sacrificed 1,000 animals, we could not get even on the one sawab what we are going to be get when we sacrifice the Qurbani on specific days. So that's why that these days are the very important. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he had sacrificed the 2 sheep with his own hands. And when he used to live in the Medina, he did sacrifice for the 10 years. So there was no logic behind it, no one asking, what logic behind we are going to be sacrificed? At once companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, why we are going to ma hazir azahir? What is this qurbani? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, hazir sunnah to abikum Ibrahim. This is the sunnah of your father Ibrahim alayhi salam. And the big stories in the Quran, When the Ibrahim alayhi salam signed the name, he is sacrificing his son Ismail for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He asked his son, he never asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why I sacrifice my son for your sake? What logic behind this? He never asked, but he just asked for the satisfaction of his son. I signed the deal, I am sacrificing you, are you willing to be sacrificed? So he said, yes, I am ready. So then Ibrahim alayhi salam took the Ismail to the Mina for sacrificing. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Falamma aslama, when they both were agreed, when they both submitted themselves to the wish of